City sidewalks, busy sidewalks, dressed in holiday style. In the air there's a feeling of Christmas. Children laughing, people passing, meeting smile after smile. And on every street corner you hear silver bells, silver bells. It's Christmas time in the city, ring-a-ling.
Patrick Ellis. Let me begin by extending a very warm welcome to you and sincere greetings for the Christmas season and my best wishes for your good health, wealth and happiness during the new year. In this DVD, I'm going to show you the story of Christmas and New Year, and in particular, how these two great internationally celebrated events are spent in cosmopolitan London by both Christians and non-Christians alike. The Christmas season in my hometown, London, is something very close to the heart of both my family and me. Over the years, having spent previous Christmases and New Year's in other countries, the great city of London holds a very special attraction to me. Here are my three reasons for saying so. Reason one, it is winter, cold, and often snows during Christmas, as it used to in the past, but nowadays with climate change, we don't see too much of it. But when it does snow, it certainly brings good cheer to Christmas. However, having spent the festive season in countries with a tropical climate, I will always hope and wish for a white Christmas as opposed to a sunshine Christmas. The snowflakes falling on a background of barren trees and the white snow-covered rooftops, cars and ground has its distinct beauty and appeal. Reason two. Let me make it clear to one and all. Christmas is a Christian festival to celebrate the birth of Christ, and long may it be that way. Many non-believers and non-practicing Christians only wish to partake in the festivity side of Christmas. Hence they have crossed out the Christ in Christmas and called it Xmas. Sadly, this is a misguided interpretation. Christmas is for all people of all faiths, whether you accept or reject the true meaning of Christmas. As the Holy Bible says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." John Chapter 3, verse 16. So for heaven's sake, please never forget to put the Christ back into Christmas, whether you are a believer or non-believer. Reason 3. It is late November, early December 2010, and I have just returned to London from a two-week holiday in Florida, USA. November 25th is Thanksgiving Day in the USA, where Americans celebrate the event in style to give thanks to God for all the bounty God has bestowed to America. It is 1 month before Christmas Day, and already the shopping malls are gaily decorated with Christmas trees, fairy lights, gifts, cards, etc. Likewise, in London, during the Christmas season, there are numerous events going on, such as Christmas parties, carol services, dances, busy Christmas shopping in gaily decorated shopping centers, and streets paved with elaborate Christmas decorations and lighting. Restaurants serving special Christmas menus, you name it, London's got it all. Now let me take you on a Christmas and New Year tour of London, visiting several different places of interest in London, showing off the festive season celebrations.
Christmas is coming to tell us all about Jesus. As the whole world prepares to celebrate, the angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, the Savior will be born on Christmas Day. See Christmas trees, Santa and Frosty the snowman, fairy lights, bonbons and all kinds of gifts, balloons, baubles and Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer. Hear carols and jolly songs to tell us Christmas is here. Christmas turkey and pud, and the wine will go around freely. Laughter and joy are bound to prevail, and we should never forget to help if we can. As they celebrate the same old Christmas Day, Christmas is coming to tell us all about Jesus. As the whole world prepares to celebrate, Christmas is coming to tell us all about Jesus. As the whole world prepares to celebrate, the angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, the Savior will be born on Christmas Day. Christmas Day, the Savior will be born on Christmas Day.
I'm in Terminal 5. This terminal building is one of the most advanced terminal buildings in the world. It's Britain's latest, and I'm standing in front of the Christmas tree in this terminal building, and I was here on the very first day of the opening on the 27th of March 2008.
got Carlo Trio's Christmas menu. I'm looking forward to reading it and possibly coming and tasting it.
I came to this very same restaurant on the day it opened and had my meal here, and here we are today. I'm trying the Italian food. It's beautiful and it gives me some very pleasant memories. I just want to see what their Christmas menu was like, and I can see a fairly comprehensive menu. I'll have to go home and study it before I make any decision to come here. Carlucci's is a very specialist Italian restaurant, and I'm sure that they will do something fantastic for Christmas.
So I bet it'd be hilarious, isn't it?
Starting like it.
Yeah. Let me know that. That's what I thought when I was at the shop. I've got to stop before getting my mate's house. Really got one more day before the buses stop anyway. I've got what he's seen. He's very good.
Yeah. Yeah. He's good, huh?
Yeah, very good. I'm surprised he hasn't got a record deal, like, you know. Someone with that sort of talent should get a record deal, you know. Sorry, Sim.
Yeah.
He definitely got the X Factor, that's for sure. You've got the style, yeah. Forget about the pound shop, get him instead. Forget about a pound aftershave. That's what I think when I get up and do the housework. Could be Jim say, one awesome sleigh, whoa-ho! Yeah. I think about it when I go running, one awesome sleigh, it's Christmas Day, bollocks.
Christmas!
It's like an old rocker, eh? I forget about going out now. I'm listening to it all the time. forget about doing anything else. So I said, where are you? I said, rock and roll, rock and roll. I switched the phone off. We don't want no.
Ooh, that's all, folks. Merry Christmas.
And to you too.
Thank you.
Happy New Year.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It doesn't show signs of stopping, and I brought some corn for popping. The lights are turned down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how I'll hate going out in the storm. But if you'll really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. The fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbying. As long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Doesn't care if it's 10 below. He's sitting by the fire's cozy glow. He don't care about the cold and the winds that blow. He just says, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Let it snow.
Ooh-wee, goes the star. Why should he worry when he's nice and warm? His gal by his side and the lights turn low. He just says, let it snow, let it snow.
I don't care.
I'm in Trafalgar Square right now, in front of this giant Christmas tree, which is the mother of all Christmas trees here in London, or may I say in the United Kingdom. It was given by the Norwegian government to the British people for the assistance that they gave them during the previous World War. This has been given for many, many years now, and as long as I've been here in the United Kingdom, I've always come here to see this Christmas tree whenever I could. And furthermore, it is when this Christmas tree is put up here in Trafalgar Square and lit up that it signals that Christmas season has started in London and the United Kingdom. I hope you like it as much as I like it.
Does he ride a red nose reindeer? Does he?
centre, the largest shopping centre in Europe, and the latest one. And I'm in Cafe Concerto, and I've just ordered a cup of tea, and hopefully I'm going to have something a little bit later on to eat. Today is Christmas Eve, and we're all very excited because tomorrow is Christmas Day, and there's a huge family get-together, and I'm sure everyone is looking forward to it, except the turkey. You know that turkeys don't vote for Christmas. I'm in Heston with Reverend Father Simon Wynne, the parish priest, on the 24th of December, Christmas Eve. And thank you very much, Father, for having invited me. We have this beautiful crib here. I must say, a lot of time and effort has gone into making this crib and all the decorations that go with it. Can you, you know, looking at these images here, can you please tell me what is the significance of all these, you know, images that we see here with the little baby Jesus for the purpose of our viewers?
So thank you very much for coming here to make an interview with our community. So this is the first time that we try our best to make a very good crib so that, you know, only parishioners, the people in this parish, they can come to worship and to see the meaning of Christmas. Christmas is all about God becoming man, and this is amazing, and we cannot understand this. This is a mystery. You can never, ever come to understand the mystery. And by choosing to become man, Jesus, you know, he wanted to share with us his divinity, and he invited us to share with him and to be with him in this divinity. We all are human beings full of weakness, but because of our Savior, he, in some way, you can say that he began the new way, the way of a new life into his kingdom, and this is the way that we are celebrating. And by becoming man, he wants all of us to share our humanity with one another, and also to understand that in everyone, there must be a God in them. So if we are welcoming Jesus, we have to welcome all our brothers and sisters who have Jesus in their soul. And this is, you know, we try our best to convey the message of Christmas to people who are coming here to see the baby Jesus, and also to understand something about the aspect of the mystery of God becoming man. Yeah.
The other thing I want to say to you, Father, is we've been filming all over London.
Yes.
And we see so much of celebrations taking place with, you know, these fairy lights and, you know, various Santa Claus inflatables and, you know, balloons and all that sort of stuff. It seems to be detached from the real world of what Christmas is all about. Mm-hmm. And I'm, you know, being a Roman Catholic myself, it is very important for me, mm-hmm. and I'm sure for everyone, for us to really grasp the meaning of Christmas from a Christian perspective, rather than just looking at it from the point of view of commercial enterprises, you know, trying to, you know, decorate their shops and offices and having various parties and getting drunk. And whilst the celebration part of it is good, I mean, the essence of it must be to give reverence to our Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes, you are right. You know, that is, you know, the meaning of our celebration, the celebration of something religious, something very holy. But, you know, we cannot escape from the reality that, you know, the story of Christmas has been commercialized. But, you know, in some way that the people, by, you know, commercializing things, they can also, you know, convey something about, you know, the message. Yes, of course, you know, we do not accept, you know, the idea of, you know, commercializing, you know, the message of Christmas. But, you know, in some way, it is the season of happiness, the season to celebrate. So this is, you know, in some way I'm quite, you know, happy that, you know, the people, they have their own way, and you should remember that not everyone are Catholic or Christian, so they have their own way of celebrating of Christmas, because Christmas is also the season of family, the season of being together with one another. So by buying gifts, by celebrating, by coming together, it is, you know, there's something that we can, even though they do not share with us the way of our celebration, but by doing this, they also contribute to the meaning of Christmas. So I think, you know, we try to include rather than, you know, just to criticize, you know, the people not the way that they are, you know, conducting.
Yes, so, the community here is so cosmopolitan that you find Hindus, Buddhists, Muslim people and various other religions all celebrating Christmas, but they forget the real meaning of it. And that's what I'm trying to emphasize in having this DVD done. The other thing I want to say is you come from Vietnam, and coming from Vietnam, do they also celebrate Christmas like they do here out in the West?
Yes, in the last 10 years. So in the last 10 years, I can say that, you know, the Christmas has become, you know, an atmosphere, you know, the phenomenon of, you know, the whole country, because, you know, now this has become very international. So even though I haven't been, you know, in any Christmas since I escaped from the country, but, you know, my friends, they told me that, you know, now the people, they are decorating the street, they decorating churches, they decorating every, you know, neighborhood. And this has become, you know, very popular in Vietnam, and I'm very pleased that, you know, it has been. So it is, you know, the way that, you know, we cannot escape that God has become man and want to share with us, you know, his divinity. So I think it is by celebrating of this, so we can bring the message of Christmas to people everywhere. And I'm very glad that in Vietnam, they have started to do it. Yes?
Fantastic. Father, may I say thank you very much. I'm going to wish you a very happy Christmas and a prosperous New Year. And later on, I'll be here to film the carols and also the Midnight Mass and to hear your sermon today. So I'm looking forward to it.
So many thanks. And Merry Christmas to you. Merry Christmas to cameraman and your whole team. Okay,
thank you. Right. Thank you, Father. Yeah.
Christmas is coming to tell us all about Jesus. As the whole world prepares to celebrate, the angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, the Savior will be born on Christmas Day. You'll see Christmas trees, Santa and Frosty the snowman, fairy lights, bonbons and all kinds of gifts, balloons, baubles and Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer. Hear carols and jolly songs to tell us Christmas is here. Christmas turkey and pud, and the wine will go around freely. Laughter and joy are bound to prevail, and we should never forget to help if we can the needy, as they celebrate the same old Christmas Day. Christmas is coming to tell us all about Jesus. As the whole world prepares to celebrate, Christmas is coming to tell us all about Jesus. As the whole world prepares to celebrate, Savior will be born on Christmas Day. The Savior will be born on Christmas Day.